Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about texture size and texel density. Most people get confused between the two, so let me break it down for you today. Let's start with the texture size. The texture size is basically the size of the texture being used. This can either be 512 pixels, 1024 pixels, 2048 pixels, or 4096 pixels, also known as 4K. This can even go as far as 8K, but that might be a bit too much for our system. Those higher textures like 8K and above are usually used by movie studios and not in video game development, especially in indie games. That's because movie renders need to look as close to real life as possible. And the higher textures you have in a video game, it is going to put a strain on your system, especially your graphics card. But texture sizes are not the only thing that makes a 3D object look realistic. You also have to take other things into consideration, like polygon count, anatomy, proper 3D mesh, etc. But those things will be discussed in another topic. And now that brings us to our next topic. Let's talk about texel density. A lot of people get confused when we talk about texture size and texel density, but these are two separate things but are often used in conjunction. Texel density, also known as pixel density or texture density, is basically the number of pixels per centimeter on the surface of the model. While texture size is basically how large your whole texture is, like 512 pixels, 1024 pixels, etc. Like I said earlier. For example, we can have an object with a texture size of 1496 pixels, and we can set the texel density to 1 pixel per centimeter. Look how this looks. As you can see, the UV grid texture looks less dense, and we can set it to 3 pixels per centimeter. Look how this looks. We can even go up to 6 pixels per centimeter. And look how the UV grids look even more dense. Now let me add an actual texture to this object so you can have a better understanding of what I am saying. Okay, so here we have a brick texture. Now let's reduce the texel density again and you will see how the texture looks. As you can see, the texture looks very low res, even though it's a 4K texture. That's because the texel density has been reduced. So to have a more crispier resolution, you need to increase the texel density of your texture. While textures are just pixel sizes, the texture density is basically the pixel sizes per centimeter, or how dense do you want these pixels to be when applied to your model. In games or 3D renders, you can quickly notice a difference in texel density between objects. You might notice one object looking very blurry, while another looks very detailed, even though they might have the same texture size. That right there is what texel density is. The lower the texel density, the lesser the image resolution will be displayed. And the higher the texel density, the more details will be displayed on an image. The texel density controls the details of the texture resolution. And even though both images may have the same texture size, a difference in texel density can make one look more detailed than the other. Now I'm sure you have an understanding of what texel density is, and I hope this tutorial was useful to you. If you would like to see more future content, click the subscribe button and the notification bell. If you would like to support the channel, head over to Patreon or buy me a coffee. The links are in the description. And thank you once again, and see you next time. Peace.